this video, we're going to talk to you about what the H-2B has looked like so far in the April cycle of 2018, and then we're going to talk about what that might mean for your business going forward into next October when you again try to apply for H-2Bs. If that sounds good to you, then stick around. Thanks for sticking with us. On this channel, the Bull City Lawyer TV, we help immigrants get reliable information to make better decisions and avoid costly mistakes on their immigration journey. And we do the same for employers who want to employ immigrants.
Today we're going to discuss what the H-2B visa looks like in the current cycle that's going on right now. But before we do that, we want to recap what happened in the previous cycle. So the previous cycle had an October 1st, 2017 start date, and it went pretty smoothly for us. The H-2B, as you know, is very complicated. There can be a lot of hiccups along the way. Luckily, we were able to receive a 100% approval rate. However, the H-2B cap, the 33,000 allotted visas, that cap was met. That cap was actually met in December, and in years past, that hasn't always been the case. So what does that mean for you? That 33,000 cap is met, meaning less visas were available for that April 1st cycle. As we all know, the April 1st cycle is far more competitive and can always use a few extra visas.
And honestly, we might still get an extension of that cap, but at this point we don't know because as Trent is about to tell you, things have gone kind of off the rails this year, even relative to the last couple of crazy years.
So now let's kind of talk about what we're seeing in this current cycle. As we mentioned, there are 33,000 visas. In the first week of January, there were over 4,000 employers filing applications for visas. This equated to over 80,000 visas. As we just mentioned, there's 33,000 visa cap, so not everyone's going to get a visa this time.
That's right. Not everyone's going to get a visa this time, and even if you applied within the first 5 days, you're not going to be assured a spot. In fact, what we've heard from the grapevine is that even if you applied on that first day, unlike years past, you're not going to be part of a big batch processing system. So if you'd applied on the first day before, there was no first come, first serve. But this year, even if you applied on the first day, and let's say you were like the 33,001st application, and that can somehow be proven through a timestamp, you might not get a visa, even though you did everything you could and were as diligent as possible. So let's talk about why that is and what some of the implications for the H-2B program might be.
Well, as we mentioned, there are 80,000 applications out there right now for visas, or at least there were one weekend. So why? Why are there 80,000 this time? You know, we don't really know. We always know that this cycle is more competitive. We know that, you know, there's the fishing industry, tourism industry, and seasonally, this is the cycle that they apply for. So that's increased numbers. However, the increase has been unprecedented, unexpected, and that's not just from us talking as attorneys. That is coming straight from the foreign labor certification. Past cycles, we might hear something back in 7, 10, maybe 14 days. It's been 6 weeks, and the Department of Labor has not answered a single application.
And in fact, they made an announcement in late January saying that they would not announce any decisions on a single application until February 20th, and then it would be on a rolling basis only. That being said, we haven't heard anything since then, and here it's February 23rd. So going forward, what are some things that you can do to make your next cycle, this October 1st, 2018 cycle, better or more successful? And then beyond that, what can you do as an employer to make your entire certification and labor searching, recruitment process, yada yada, better going forward into infinity?
Well, the thing we always tell clients is plan ahead. If you are even considering the October 1st cycle, right now is when you need to be gathering all your documents, your contracts, making sure your books are kind of up to par, you have everything documented, and you want to get to an attorney pretty quickly. Each cycle is getting even more competitive as we go. And I think if you watch some of our other videos, we've always said you could potentially go through this without an attorney. That's becoming less true each cycle.
The second tip is think about not just one recruitment cycle strategy, but think about your recruitment strategy as a multi-cycle thing, maybe a multi-year thing.
Right. If you're thinking maybe October 1st is good for you, but you're not sure, you know, you're kind of swamped right now, you're not sure if you're going to be able to get everything done, kind of find all those contracts, start finding the contracts now. Start saving the contracts that come up later, because maybe this year isn't your cycle. Like we said, it can be really intense, lots of documents, it's getting more competitive, but maybe if you wait till next October, you have all the documents documents already gathered. That way, your application can be even stronger than ever.
So, rule of thumb is if you're in a good place with your books and your organization and your planning as a company, you should be thinking about what you need to do and start doing it 6 to 8 months before your date of need. The second rule of thumb is if you're a company that's just getting started, if you're still organizing, if you're still trying to become established, then you should be thinking about this a year or more in advance so that you can lay down the preparatory groundwork to be successful when the cycle comes.
Right. Potentially, you don't know if you need 2 employees, 5 employees. You're not really sure which seasons are your busiest. Maybe summer seems busiest, but you don't really know where that cutoff is. Start thinking about that now. Start documenting your contracts kind of as the money comes in. See where that money's coming from, what time of year you're getting it. All of those things will be very useful for your application.
Final thing is don't just think about H-2Bs, but maybe you're a business that can take advantage of some of the other H visas that are available. Talking about the H-2As, and then the H-3s.
There are industries that, you know, fall under the H-2B category for sure, but that doesn't mean they only fall under the H-2B category. And some other visas have, you know, better benefits for employees and employers. So when you're looking at this, if you're talking to your attorney, kind of ask them, you know, I like the H-2B visa program, I'm interested in it, but what else could my business possibly qualify for?
And if you're a landscaper, for example, very well could be that you have some sort of work that could qualify for H-2A visa workers, right? If you are a construction worker that also might be doing some construction out on farms, you also might qualify for the H-2A. You should ask, you should evaluate that. H-3 is the training visa, so this would fall for some like niche businesses, and you can always talk to a lawyer about that.
Right, there are no rules set in stone that says agriculture has to go here, farming has to go here. Everything is a case-by-case analysis. Yes, there are some general rules that tend to apply, but just remember, everything is case-by-case, every business is unique. So really think about, you know, what is my business? What does my business look like moving forward? Could I dive into this other sector to take advantage of certain visa programs?
And that's it. And if you like this video, just know that we have a whole H-2B visa playlist that you should also check out.
If you like this video, subscribe, follow us, tag us, ask us questions, share it with your friends, all of it.